Hey there, hi there, how's it going? We're here, we're doing the thing, we're live, and double check that everything is okay here on my. Yep, okay. And we've got Guy Savage down here. That's what I was doing last time, I think. Yeah, this time we just beat Volgan. Not this time. We beat Volgan last time, but we didn't kill him yet. So, time has come to beat the Shagoad. Yes, our crocodile cap stays. But first, backpack. We've got unlimited everything. So let's take out all of these, but there is one thing we need. Perfect. Sorry. Backpack. I was wrong. We needed one more thing. I did not kill him. Someone threw a goddamn... Everybody's gonna be okay. We don't actually need to kill anyone here. Alright, now we just need to make sure that this happens correctly. Very, very cool segment. I forget if I can't hit or hurt it yet, or if I need to be out on the tarmac, but we are getting there anyway. And it's better to have everything equipped. Volgan's gonna absolutely destroy it, even though he really doesn't need to.
I can't shake him.
The RPG can't put a dent in that armor.
Let's head for the rail bridge.
Bridge? I thought you rigged it with C3.
I did. We'll lure him onto the bridge.
Blow him up along with it. Good plan.
The bridge is on the other side of the runway. We'll have to cut through the middle of the base. You're
ready? Right. Yes, so the RPG is absolutely not the thing I should be using. Got it.
Okay, here we go.
You had one try, Ocelot. It was a good one, but you got one. Ah! Apparently everyone in this universe can bunny hop a motorcycle, even if they've barely been invented. Oh, I love the spur! The spurs dragging the ground is so good. Oh, that makes sense. Now we race through a burning building as our motorcycles collide. He does us the actual favor of slowing us down, so that I may rocket-propelled grenade this junk and get the hell out. Also saving Ocelot's life in the incident. Hooray! We are the good guy once more. Let's just equip this and worry about them in a bit, because we don't actually have to fire here. Here we do, but... Oh, okay. Well, if you're the only one that I've got to worry about... Trying. You know, contrary to popular belief, this is not easy. Okay, we got it. We got it. Shagohod first. I'm gonna turn that down just a touch, right around there. It growls. These guys had no idea what was coming for them. Of course he doesn't care about his own soldiers. The Grulukovich men do not matter. Or the Gru men do not matter. Nor does this helicopter, really. It is in his way, so it must no longer be. And his tank will stand up to it. Everything else might not, but his tank will. Yep. I am bad at game. Hold still, Ava, and I'll be able to shoot them. All right, we got most of them. We did miss one, but that's not going to be of an issue here in just a moment. Ugh. What type of aircraft is that? I think it's made up for this game, but then again, I don't know. May have just been some sort of Russian transport from back in the day, but at the same time, that looks weird as shit.
I've got a surprise for you. You won't be getting away this time.
Poor Ocelot. That is the worst space to be. Behind a turbo engine that's just started, man, he should have absolutely been legitimately thrown back. Nah, that's not how that works. Especially not a turbojet that's doing that shit. Uh-uh. There's my field of expertise, so... Oh, okay, I should actually keep the 1911 in now because... Yeah, you gotta hit the treads to keep or make them spin out. That we did the entire time. Now we get to turn towards the bridge. Get that leverage and side saddle. Beautiful. I don't think that squeak is how that would sound, but then again, it's solid metal against concrete, so it's definitely that type of squeak, but there's still a lot there. To be a mechanic.
Snake, we've only got one chance. We'll lure him over towards the other side. When the Shadowhat is on the bridge, shoot the explosives. The bomb is planted on the strut.
One shot. Do not miss your chance to blow. This opportunity comes once in a lifetime. You've gotta shoot the bridge. And this leads to a different boss fight that's still kind of cool, but nowhere near as cool as just this spot. Gotta locate the bomb. Bridge dies just as it's trying to get across. Bam. Oh, poor Ocelot. He has not had a lot of luck with this motorcycle thing, has he? Not at all.
We did it.
Sorry, go the other way. So you think. Surprisingly, how most of my ends run in a stealth suit with the zombie face paint. We gotta take out the scar in the back.
On one condition, though, leave the fighting to me.
You got it. I was getting tired of running away anyway.
Eva, let's do it.
And it's the first time we were actually looking at her face as well.
For luck.
Man, super good. They start to actually work in a symbiotic team. He looks at her face for the first time instead of objectifying her form, which she seemed to want, but at the same time, because she's also an intelligence agent. So, you know. I mean, I did just have the RPG. Hold on. Three, two, one. Where are you going, Ava? Come on.
Why is this happening?
Working.
And first phase done. Now we get a second phase. Second phase is going to be when Volgan climbs out on top of the Shagohod and takes direct control.
Did we beat him?
No.
Now we have a new target to hit. And I think this one can be done with Trank Bullets, and if it can, I shall try. If it can't, then we're just gonna rocket launcher him. It's just what's gonna happen. Ugh. Nearly lost an arm.
Come on, you blockhead. Huh?
Looks like there are anti-aircraft guns and things around that I could use too. Fade to white, give us our ability to control back. Yeah.
Open fire now.
Beating too much. Fine. Did no damage, so. Alright, now it's just an exercise in staying alive. I'd like to see you try. Come on, my man. Gonna have to do better than that. He is very upset. Wow. That's the first time I've seen that one, this round. I don't know if I've ever seen that one before, but... Fine, he can't do much damage with that part of the Shagohod. Fine, I'll take that too. Let's just heal our burns real quick. Ointment, disinfectant, and bandage. Nope. It's just ointment and bandage. Alright. I'll put a disinfectant on there either way, because that's a good thing to do. Get hurt. Alright, grenade takes his attention. Too early. Way too early. Fine, I'll take that hit. Because you really can't hurt me if I just do this. Alright, now Ava just needs to hit you with a grenade. you gonna do? You really do just got nothing. Now we'll go ahead and eat, because we've got too much food already. No good. Oh, the glow caps are still available. Nice! Fine. Shoot me, coward. Oh, that's right, you can't, can you? I don't even need to, I can just run under him? Cool. Not even doing damage. Just kind of here. Just wait until she pulls him away, and then we can get the last hit. Because she's gonna pull him away soon.
What have you done?
Oh shit! Didn't realize it was that far out. Didn't realize I was that far in. What? Got him! And non-lethal. Ooh! All right. And that was the worst Bulgan fight, but it's the most absurd fight until, like, Metal Gear Rising. And I love myself some Metal Gear Rising. Not gonna lie. Never noticed those wires going nuts before. No! 1.21 gigawatts straight to the brain. Then his ammo belt just starts shooting the fuck out of him. Well, you don't wear live ordnance around yourself with a lightning dude. Dumbass. Yo, Wisdom. Nice to see you. Going all right. We're out of Bulgan's territory, but we're going to fight the boss soon. So we're about to finish our third game in a week. Which is ridiculous. Oh, and Metal Gear Solid 3 is a love story too. Gotcha.
No time for this now. The escape craft is just up ahead.
Doing this non-lethal as non-lethal as we can. We're going to be using trank darts as our main weapon, so going to be a little difficult, but you know, hey, it is what it is. Doing it. Just not easy. My predictions need to be stronger. No more motorcycles for the moment. Alright, again, motorcycles are out. Okay. Bad. It's fine. It's fine. It's fine.
Over there.
Tried to take out some of them, but I didn't get any of the stationary guys, but that's fine. We took out all the motor vehicles, and that's what matters. that guy's still alive, then kudos to him, but I don't think he's explosion proof. I need to find the right angle to get him. There was a log. Damn. Yep. I do. I need to be close by with the RPGs from now on. I need to be on time, but it's fine. But how are you doing with them? Wisdom? My guy. Where did he come from? Oh, good. The motorcycle took out the other motorcycle. Did this one work out? Yes, this is the one that works. Not bad at all.
Looks like so, gave up.
Don't start we have decision to make.
Damn it. Tank
shot. First things first. Yes, we will put out the pull one more time.
Crap.
But set it for 10. Pole's going out, but no, that's the first one. That's the idea, like, for the end of the game. Checking again now that we're all here. Do we fire the Colt? But the decision we need to make is, do we continue on in chronological order,
how's it look?
Or do I take the opportunity
pretty bad
to go in game order? So the question is, Portable Ops or Metal Gear Solid 4?
I'm fine.
I think 4 should go literally as the last one that we play. I think 5 would be a good next one to go through, but you kind of need Portable Ops, or not Portable Ops, but Peace Walker. Peace Walker, or or four. And a Peace Walker is what leads into five, so we would need to play Peace Walker to play five, so that would be the chronological order of games.
I can't believe this. I never thought I'd see you act this weak.
What do you mean?
Listen to me, Eva. We're doing this together.
No, you...
Eva, I need you.
Say that one more time.
I need you. I can't fly the wig by myself.
All right, then. I guess I'd better help you out.
If you're ever in this situation, by the way, if you are ever impaled on something wooden like that, absolutely just break that shit off inside of you.
You're lucky.
Because if it goes through that way, it could, or if it goes through one way, you don't know how many splinters it's had or how many it'll leave inside of you. There is no way to do that without surgical like help that's going to be anything good. So yes, if you are ever impaled by an object, seek medical help, and if it's not just a straight medical thing, or like a... If you get a nail through you, you can probably pull it out of your body, but something wooden like that, break it off inside you. But you're the only break it off, just, or cut the ends. Leave it there. You'll save more blood, and you can bandage around it, and then some medical professional will be able to help you later.
I'm running kind of short.
Then by switching the survival viewer over to Eva, you can treat her wounds too. Now get to work. Oh, and Snake, I'm pretty sure you know this already, but if you don't have enough supplies for the both of you, your wounds come first. Huh? Do you get my meaning, Snake? You've still got a mission to complete.
Yeah.
I don't have wounds at the moment, so we're good.
Snake?
We got this taken care of. The game's gonna do a, no, it's not. Good. Suffering from a deep cut. Tree branch bleeding. Okay. Suturing her up was absolutely the right choice. I can do whatever I want for myself after this. And this is a very entertaining part of the game. The escort mission!
It's different from the Mauser. When you're using a two-hand grip, you have to be careful where you put your hands or your fingers will get burned by the exhaust gas from the cylinder gap.
Snake's also a bit of a nerd. And definitely socially inept. I love it. All of our grenades are full, all of our bullets are full, we'll grab the rations, all of these bullets are full, so, now it's time to cure ourselves. Oh, okay. Alright, so, styptic first, disinfect, Sutures. Nope. Didn't want the knife. Bandage. Oh, it's a gunshot. Or is it a burn? Oh, bone fracture. I wasted a lot of things on that bone fracture. I just realized.
Do you know what you're doing? Are you stupid or something?
Yes. Yes, I am. Okay, Ava, food. Eat your cookie.
Let me have some more.
Maybe. Yeah, since our cages are empty. That was a good kill. Alright, come on.
What do you think you're doing?
Waiting for you. Come on.
Do you know what you're doing?
Scouting. Okay, and now we get both our answer to will we fire the cult and ambushed. Pierce volts are in for our 10-minute poll. Oh, nope, it's close. Anybody who hasn't put their vote in, please do so now. Looks like yeses have it. Who saw me and where? Food. Articulated python is only for me to eat. Russian rations. Nope, I gotta be closer to Ava to give her food.
Thank you.
come on.
This tastes like crap. Can I have seconds?
Nope. Not the one I wanted equipped anyway. I want you to stay put over here. Never mind, come this way.
Are you stupid or something?
Nope. Just want you to be able to hide as I go and do all the rest of this. Don't actually kill the python with the... okay. Come on. Come on, Ava. Just keep going. We need you to keep moving for now. Because everybody's coming from behind us, so... I understand the more you move right now is the worst. I'll feed you some python. Alright, now, food, Ava.
Well, not bad at all.
Come on.
Are you stupid or something?
Let's go. This way. Ava, best be coming. Ava. Come on. This way. They're gonna be waking up the other guard soon. Come on. I'm waiting for you. If you don't see me, like, every 3 steps, you're just gonna fall behind. Come on. Get in the damn thing. Come on. Sorry. Come on. No. This way.
What do you think you're doing?
Asking you to come with me so that we can get across this bridge? Ava. Alright, come on.
Do you know what you're doing?
Food, you're getting the false mango. Ava, where are you? Ava, come on. Come on. They're asleep. They're not dead. Should have another false mango. I gave you food. Come on. What? No! God damn it. How'd I go backwards? Okay, backpack, first things first. I need to slim down, so we're gonna keep that on. We're gonna drop the SVD, we're gonna drop the RPG. Cool. We got the AP sensor. We don't need it. We don't have another calorie mate. We do have to go down this way. How'd I get turned around? We're gonna have to give her a ration. Hmm. disgusting, but it'll do better.
Yuck.
Nothing. Actually, come this way. I'll feed you a python, giggity. Actually, backpack. Looks like there's a, cool. Pair of mangoes. Food.
What did you give me?
Getting you food, what I think I'm doing. Okay, so it is this way. Gotta be this way. It's just we went the wrong way the first time. Yes, come on. This way. Still this way. Wait, so, wait. Where am I supposed to go then? Okay, because we started over here, I'm going to go back, because I am absolutely stupid.
Well, not bad at all.
Yes, I am. Now come on, please. Over there. This log. It's very far away. Eh, they're out. Not like it matters. Yeah, I'm waiting for her. All right, we've got it. Got it good. Hopefully. Hopefully I can keep this up. Absolutely insane. Come on down. Okay, come on. Wait, Ava's being hurt? Come on, let's go. Here, take a python.
Well, not bad at all.
Oh, you? Okay, fine. Okay, so here's this, triangle to go down to one. I want those false mangoes that are above me.
What do you think you're doing?
That's fine. Oh, she's way too far away. Got it. Nope. Come on. Yep, I know what I'm doing. Come on. I'm going to look at the map, because I need to know we're close. Okay. Ava, come on down. Where is he? He's here. Shooting me. Yes, I know, Ava. I will get it for you as soon as I can. But for now, Let me take care of... Where am I being shot from? Oh, this way. There you are. Where am I being shot from? This way? Ah, there you are. Yep, fine. Actually hoping he would drop a ration. Okay, Ava, I'm coming back. You'll get a calorie mate whenever I'm there. I need to get there first. Come on.
I think I can walk again.
No, I'm asking you to come. I've taken care of everything in our path. Now let's go. Okay, let's do it. Are you coming? Yeah, good. Because I need to start searching bodies for some ammo because I'm running at low on M22 ammo. Good. Okay. Ava, you still following? Where'd she end up? There she is. Cool. Ava, come on. I'll feed you once we get through. So, let's get through. Let's do it. Let's do all the things we need to do to get to the boss, because that is what matters. Wait, why is it? I have no idea. Ah! We're here! We're at the final boss fight.
Come on, Snake. We made it.
Over there. And I am stacked for consumable items.
It's the boss, isn't it? I'll go get the wig ready to take off.
Okay, so the wig.
Right.
I wonder what wigs are, if they're just for this or not. And now we fight the joy of battle.
Life's end. Isn't it beautiful? It's almost tragic. When life ends, it gives off a final lingering aroma. Light is but a farewell gift from the darkness to those on their way to die. I've been waiting.
I don't see a
waiting for
I see an analog to it.
Your growth and the finality of today.
Boss. Why are you doing this?
Why? To make the world one again.
Yeah. That ugly looking plane actually existed.
But with the end of the Second World War, the philosophers began to fight amongst themselves, and the world was torn apart. The Cobras, my comrades, who trained and fought alongside me, were torn apart as well. The foibles of politics and the march of time can turn friends into enemies just as easily as the wind changes. Ridiculous, isn't it? Yesterday's ally becomes today's opposition, and this Cold War... Think back. When I was leading the Cobras, America and Russia were fighting together. Now, consider whether America and Russia will still be enemies in the 21st century.
I mean, it's sad how we still are, but
enemies change along
we shouldn't
the
be.
Times, the flow of the ages, and we soldiers are forced to play along.
Agreed.
I didn't raise you and shape you into the man you are today, just so we could face each other in battle. A soldier's skills aren't meant to be used to hurt friends. So then what is an enemy? Is there such a thing as an absolute timeless enemy? There is no such thing, and never has been. And the reason is that our enemies are human beings like us. They can only be our enemies in relative terms. The world must be made whole again. The philosophers must be reunited. I will devote my skills to that purpose.
You know?
And with the Colonel's money, I will achieve...
Not a worse... Not an entirely bad, idea.
They are my family. I may no longer be able to bear children. But I still have a family.
Oh, and the boss is essentially just Black Widow, by the way, if you haven't picked up on it.
1951. I was in the Nevada desert, participating in atomic testing. The name Nevada is derived from Spanish. Covered in snow, white as snow. And snow is exactly what I saw in that Nevada desert. It froze my blood white. Snake, you were an atomic test subject, weren't you? On Bikini Atoll. That's part of the reason I was drawn to you. You and I are alike. We're both slowly being eaten away by the karma of others.
Yeah.
We'll never
Although,
have a chance to die peacefully of old age. We have no tomorrow. But we can still have hope.
We'll wait for Metal Gear Solid 4.
In 1960,
I saw a vision of the ideal future from space. 3 years
I'll have to go through 5 before I get to 4. Or it's going to be the end of it outside of Revengeance, because Revengeance is Revengeance. And then we can probably play Portable Ops or Acid after that.
In response, America threw everything it had into its own manned spaceflight project, the Mercury program. Even as the Soviets seemed poised to send their first man into space, America was still experimenting with chimpanzees and rockets. The government wanted human data. So they secretly decided to send a human being into space.
Can you guess who that was?
I was the one they chose. At the time, they didn't have the technology to block out cosmic rays, and whoever they sent up would inevitably be exposed to heavy radiation. That's why they chose me. After all, I'd already been irradiated once. Of course, you won't find any of this in the history books. I could see the planet as it appeared from space. That's when it finally hit me. Space exploration is nothing but another game in the power struggle between the US and the USSR. Politics, economics, the arms race, they're all just arenas for meaningless competition. I'm sure you can see that, but the Earth itself has no boundaries. No East, no West, no Cold War. And the irony of it is, the United States and the Soviet Union are spending billions on their space programs and the missile race, only to arrive at the same conclusion. In the 21st century, everyone will be able to see that we are all just inhabitants of a little celestial body called Earth.
So much optimism.
A world without communism or capitalism, that is the world I wanted to see.
A true anarchist beauty.
The
boss.
In 1961, I was sent to Cuba, to Bahía de Cochinos.
The Bay of Pigs.
It was part of a CIA-sponsored invasion under the guise of taking Cuban exiles back to their country. But the U.S. government betrayed them. Our weak-kneed president held back their air support.
Yep.
Defenseless, the exiles were annihilated by the Cuban army. All I could do.
And it was a huge, huge scar on America because of our tendency to try and overthrow fucking communist dictators. We decided, we're not gonna do air support for our ground invasion because that'll make sure that it looks like us. And we don't want to look like us. We want to have plausible deniability.
He was my friend. But one of us had to die. I was left with no choice. The sorrow gave his life for me. There is no enmity between us. One must live, and one must die. That was the mission. The ones who gave me that mission were the philosophers.
Maybe the mission was unjust.
Early in the 20th century, the true holders of power in the United States, the Republic of China, and the newly formed Soviet Union, gathered together in a secret meeting that would later be known as the Wiseman's Committee. The secret pact.
This is alternate history.
The beginning of the philosophers. But the last of the original members died in the 1930s. After that, the organization began to run out of control. And the Wiseman's Committee degenerated into a mere shell of its former self. The philosophers of today have no sense of good or evil. Their influence extends to countries and organizations involved in every aspect of every war. They have become war itself. That's how they operate. The sacrifices of war cause a shift in the times. This shift leads to renewed conflict, and in turn triggers the next war. Like a nuclear chain reaction, each conflict sparks countless others, forming an endless spiral that will continue on for eternity. Do you understand what I'm saying, Snake?
I understand completely.
The philosophers intend to keep that cycle going forever.
Because that still sounds like the truth of the real world for that one.
He was one of them. You see, I am the last remaining child of the philosophers. But after he revealed the truth, my father was killed by that same shapeless, formless organization. And my father isn't the only thing the philosophers have taken from me. In June of 1944, the Cobras and I took part in the landing at Normandy. We'd been given a top-secret mission to locate and destroy enemy V-2 rocket installations. I was pregnant at the time. The sorrow was the father. I gave birth on the field of battle. A beautiful baby boy. But my child was snatched away from me by the philosophers.
Yeah, that's also a theme that's constantly played on. Much like Olga, the boss had her child stolen in the field of battle.
Look at this scar. This is proof that I was once a mother. I gave up my body and my child for my country. There is nothing left inside me now. Nothing at all. No hatred, not even regret. And yet sometimes at night, I can still feel the pain creeping up inside me, slithering through my body like a snake.
Ah.
I've never talked this much about myself before. Thanks. Thanks for listening to me. I feel content. Snake, commence the operation. I raised you. I loved you. I've given you weapons. Taught you techniques, endowed you with knowledge. There is nothing more for me to give you. All that's left for you to take is my life, by your own hand. One must die, and one must live. No victory, no defeat. The survivor will carry on the fight. It is our destiny. The one who survives will inherit the title of boss. And the one who inherits the title of boss will face an existence of endless battle.
Honestly,
I'll give you 10.
I should have saw a boss coming a long time before what I did as a dumb child.
The hell out of this place.
But
if you can beat me in less than 10 minutes, you'll be able to escape in time.
I didn't.
Let's make this the greatest 10 minutes of our lives, Jack.
Boss.
You're a soldier. Finish your mission. Prove your loyalty. Face me.
All right, boss. If that's what you want.
Let's see what you're made of. What's this for? Are you out of your mind? Heads up, Snake.
Already starting out strong. Oh, good. I'll wait for a second just to get my bearings. How am I missing with every shot? Nope, not that. Snow is the one that I want. And face will be... yeah. There's a gunshot wound in my future. Cool. All right, and this one's also... oh shit, of course she was right there. Oh no. There she is. She's moving slowly, but she's moving this way. So, let's keep this at hand, because if we can get a good shot, we can absolutely take her out. But it's going to be difficult, because... white field... This is where, if I still had mouse traps, I should probably use them, but... I don't need to be close to her, but I do need to land more hits than this in the first 5 minutes.
Huh.
Good. Great.
Let's see what you're made of.
Kill me, please. I want to start this over. Dead. Perfect. Okay. Now I know what to do. Because I've refreshed. We can absolutely beat the boss today.
Let's see what you're made of. What's this for?
Okay.
Are you out of the room? Heads up.
Camouflage, uniform, back to snow. All right, come on back.
There you go. You're wasting time. Where did you go? Get ready.
All right. I love how my big dumb croc head's not giving me away. Perfect. Now let's lay down, because now she's in cover. Let's sit up. I have no idea where she's at, but she'll find... Ah, there she is. He's kind of coming close to me, too, so... Got it.
He's gone.
All Alright, so she's behind there.
You've gotten stronger. I told you that wouldn't work. You can't get me. Here I come.
Alright, I've got to make the next shots count because I don't have any more non-lethal ammo outside of the Mosin, and I really shouldn't be using the Mosin in this fight. Actually, let's use the Mosin.
Where are you hiding?
Damn it.
Run quick. Five more minutes.
Okay, and there we go. Alright, so let's cure our... Yeah. No chill, this woman. That's fine. I missed.
I found you. Get ready. All these years and still nothing to show. Head down. Seven more minutes.
Where are you hiding? Silence through the night. There he is. How?
You better run.
Where are you? Come on. Come on, turn around. Boss fight over. And non-lethal. We did it. Snake Eater is almost done. We've got one more major thing to do, and it was fire the cult. So this is generally the standard ending. Whenever you fire, if you don't, it's technically different, but it's all the same. Keep it safe.
It's our only hope. A patriot. Why are you giving me this?
Jack. Or should I say, Snake. You're a wonderful man. Kill me. Kill me now.
So, the big trick of Metal Gear Solid 3 is that no run is ever technically killless.
There's only room for one boss and one snake.
Because the game will absolutely not progress from this spot until you fire. And while I'll contest that I did not kill the rest of the Cobra Union, because I used non-lethal means and they blew themselves up in fantastic form, those shouldn't be on my conscience. But the boss, the game forces you to fire. The master dies so that the student may live, and now for the final portion gameplay before the credits roll, and I will let the credits roll because that's tradition around here. You've got to give full credit for the people who made the game that you enjoy so much. And
are you okay?
For me in particular, this game is probably my favorite. There's no real reason it should be. Or is there a reason it shouldn't?
I told you you could trust me.
And that's why my M16's gone in this next one. Oh, well, I mean, with one engine out, yeah, I suppose it would be too heavy. Arm bars are really effective generally, and so are hammer locks, which you've seen both of them use. The flips are kind of not necessary, but they are ways to get out of things with counter torsion. But if you've got a smart enemy, they can use that and force you to over rotate. If he had bent it back, it would have been a better like joint lock than rolling it forward, but
it doesn't feel right to shoot an unarmed man, but I'll get over it. Eva,
now our big Mexican standoff.
What do you say to one last showdown?
Yeah, all right.
The bullet from the beginning. Were you paying attention? Good, because it doesn't matter.
What's your name?
Snake.
No, not that name. You're not a snake, and I'm not an ocelot. We're men with names. My name is Ademska. What's yours?
John.
Very well, John. Plain name. But I won't forget it. Come on!
All right, 3, 2, left. Since we decided to fire, I'm just going to mash square until a bullet. And that's time. I hope you all enjoyed Metal Gear Solid 3. I certainly did. And we'll be here next week with Peace Walker. But until then, I hope you all enjoy the end of Metal Gear Solid 3. Thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. Thanks for sticking around. Appreciate you all. Be back Wednesday with more Mass Effect 2. Friday will be Armored Core, the original. And Saturday will be Digimon World 3. Those will be at Wednesday and Friday, 4 p.m., same time as this one, GMT minus 7. The 6 p.m., GMT minus 7. And for Saturday, we are doing a longer stream, 3 p.m., and 6 p.m. all times, again, GMT minus 7. So, okay. Form and 6. Okay. Swear I'm trying.
No way out. What are we gonna do?
We've come too far to let them stop us now. Those things have got to be armed.
It's no use. There's no way we can outmaneuver them. They're gonna shoot us down. We were so close.
Weapon systems on.
Locked on target. I got towed.
Great, Eva.
Huh?
Thanks.
Well done, Snake.
The MiG's disengaged.
Most likely under orders from Khrushchev.
Is this his way of helping us?
Who knows? Maybe he didn't want things to get messier than they already are. Or maybe he just wanted us to owe him one. The important thing is, you made it out alive. As long as Khrushchev is with us, I don't think they'll be coming after you. It should be smooth sailing all the way to Alaska. I'm sending someone out to Galena Base to meet you.
To meet me?
The DCI and the President himself are waiting at Langley. Don't keep them waiting.
So what are you going to do now? Go back to the KGB?
What do you want me to do?
Did you ever think about coming back to America?
I can't go back. I've left America behind me.
But you saved this country.
I didn't do it alone.
And I still owe you a dinner.
Is that part of your mission, too? Or is it an order? Or is it an invitation? Or a proposal? I don't take orders from anyone now.
Not the only one afraid.
Scholars tell us that the first spy in history was the snake in the book of Genesis. In that story, it was Eve who was tempted by the snake in the Garden of Eden. But this time around, it was I who tempted the snake and got away with the forbidden fruit of knowledge. Forgive me, snake. I wasn't sent by Khrushchev. I'm not a KGB spy, and I never worked for the NSA.
I'm an agent of the People's Republic of China for the General HQ Second Department of the People's Liberation Army. It was all a lie. I tricked you. And I'm sorry.
The philosophers still exist in China, too. You see, my mission was to find out where Volgan was hiding the philosopher's legacy and steal it. So I infiltrated his base as a KGB spy. The two NSA codebreakers who defected in 1960 were actually both men. The real Adam never showed up at the meeting place, saving me the trouble of having to eliminate him. I sneaked in by pretending I was Eva. And you and Sokolov and Volgan, you all believed me. The philosopher's legacy was originally held in common between the US, Soviet Union, and China. We couldn't let the Russians and the Americans take it all for themselves. The Chinese government had its eye on the legacy too. I got the film containing the legacy, and also the nuclear missile launch data from the Shagohod. 5 years ago, the Soviet Union stopped supplying us with nuclear weapons technology. Since then, China's Liaodong easing, hydrogen bomb, and space rocket projects have fallen behind. But with this data, our country will be able to develop its own nukes. We'll create a deterrent force to rival those of the US and Soviet Union. Everything has gone according to plan. Thanks to your help. I too am one of the philosophers. I'm an agent of the philosophers, a graduate of one of their charm schools. I was raised in a joint US-Soviet-Chinese facility to become a sleeper agent. This was before the war. Back then, they were collecting children from all over the world. As a result, I'm indistinguishable from a native-born American. So it didn't surprise me when you and Volgan couldn't tell the difference. But she knew right from the beginning. She knew because before the war, she was at one of the philosopher's schools too, as an instructor. The boss was the only one I couldn't fool. She was the only one who knew I was a fake. She told me everything. Why did she open her heart to me like that? At the time, I couldn't understand it. But now, I think I do. Snake, she wanted you to know the truth. She chose me to tell you. That's why she saved my life. I've lied to you so many times, but not this time. My orders from the government were to obtain the legacy and to eliminate everyone who knew the truth about what happened. In other words, I'm supposed to kill you. do it. Not because we loved each other. And not because you saved my life. But because I made a promise to the boss. And I intend to keep it. I just wanted you to know. And you have to live. Snake, listen to me. She didn't betray the United States. No. Far from it. She was a hero who died for her country. She carried out her mission knowing full well what was going to happen. Self-sacrifice. Because that was her duty.
Even the boss. I hereby award you the title of Big Boss. You are a true patriot.
Someone like him to handle our top secret sneaking missions for us. A man who combines the qualities of a soldier and an agent.
The boss's defection was a ruse set up by the U.S. government. It was all a big drama staged by Washington so they could get their hands on the philosopher's legacy. And the boss was the star of the show. They planned it so that they could get the legacy that Colonel Volgan inherited and destroy the Shagohod at the same time. Only a legendary hero like the boss could have earned Volgan's trust. Finding out where the philosopher's legacy was hidden was to be her greatest mission. Everything was going according to plan. But then something happened that no one could have predicted. Colonel Volgan fired an American-made nuclear warhead at Sokolov's research facility. Khrushchev demanded that the U.S. government provide proof that it wasn't involved. They couldn't just abort the operation to steal the legacy. So the operation itself was greatly expanded and revised. The authorities in Washington knew that in order to prove its innocence, they'd have to get rid of the boss. And that one of their own would have to do the job. The public couldn't be allowed to find out about it. Not ever. This, they concluded, would be the best way to keep the whole thing under wraps. The boss wouldn't be allowed to come back home alive. And she wouldn't be allowed to kill herself. Her life would be ended by her most beloved disciple. That was the way the government wanted it. That was the mission she was given. And she had no choice but to carry it out. Her death at your hands was a duty she had to fulfill. out of duty, she turned her back on her own comrades. A lesser woman would have been crushed by such a burden. The taint of disgrace will follow her to her grave. Future generations will revile her. In America, as a despicable traitor with no sense of honor. And in Russia, as a monster who unleashed a nuclear catastrophe. She will go down in official history as a war criminal. And no one will ever understand her. That was her final mission. And like a true soldier, she saw it through to the end. But I think she wanted you, of all people, to know the truth. She wanted to live on, in your memory. Not as a soldier, but as a woman. But she was forbidden to tell you herself. And that's why she told me. Snake. History will never know what she did. No one will ever learn the truth. Her story, her debriefing, will endure only in your heart. Everything she did for her country. She sacrificed her life and her honor for her native land. She was a real hero. She was a true patriot.
Yes, Groznygrad and the Granin Research Facility have both been wiped out without a trace. I understand, sir, but they were necessary sacrifices. Yes, the CIA has taken care of the boss themselves. I believe the White House will be satisfied. Khrushchev is finished. Your time has finally arrived. Yes, the American president is relying on us to keep a lid on the whole affair. We've got him by the balls. It should make a valuable trump card in future negotiations. Yes, Chief Director, of course. I'll keep the KGB informed. Yes, it's me. The boss has accomplished her mission. The philosopher's legacy is now safely with us, in America's hands. With this money, yes, the philosophers can finally be revived. The film we handed the Chinese was a fake. Peking must be in an uproar right about now. I'm afraid so. Only half the money has made it back to the United States. The KGB must still have part of the legacy. Yes, the weapon has been reduced to ashes. That's right. Groznygrad has been obliterated by the Davy Crockett we brought in as well. Yes, that was the boss's work, too. Speaking of which, I've obtained something from Granin that you might find interesting. It's a revolutionary new nuclear attack system. Perhaps it might just come in handy someday. Yes, we have John, Snake, to thank for that. Khrushchev believed it as well. Yes, they bought our story. I don't think they'll be making a fuss. The secondary alert has been lifted as well. And the Soviets still haven't discovered my true identity. They have no idea that I've been triple-crossing them. I will continue my activities as a contact for the new government. Yes, it appears that no one knew that I was Adam. Of course, I'm always at the CIA's disposal, Mr. Director.